فاشرف بي لاشتغالي بالعلم ولا تبغي به ما عشت يا ذا بدلا ويا له من شرف عظيم.
وللنصب خمس علامات: الفتحة والألف والكسرة والياء وحرف النون.
Now we finished the first type of علامات الإعراب, right? Which one was the first علامة of علامات الإعراب? الرفع. We did, صح? And we did four signs are in the رفع. One is أصل, which is the حركة, which is ضمة. And three are what? فروع. Sub branches. They are not the أصل. And what is it? واو, ألف, نون. Are you with me, brothers? Very good. The way I remember it all the time is, do it in order, brothers. You guys mentioned the waw before the alif, right? It's better to mention the alif first. The reason why I say it's better to put the alif first is because the alif is muthanna. The muthanna should take next right after the mufrad. So bring the muthanna. So do it in that order so you can remember it. So say alif, and then after that is waw, and the last one is what? The waw and the noon, do it in that order. The reason is because waw and noon is the jamra dhakr salim sign. Huh? If you want, you can make it into one word and say own. So I own these three. Own. Are you with me? Do things like that to remind you. Yeah? Are you with me? For example, huruf illa, which are the three defected letters, I always remember them. Why? Why? That's what it is, waw, alif, ya, right? Why? Huh? It helps me. That's how I remember it. You find your little tricks, how to memorize things, sah? I'm sure people who memorize the Quran have these little tricks they memorize the Quran with, sah? Little letters that it kicks off a thought in your mind and you do this little, huh? It's things that you do. So make yourself memorize it like that. Now he moves on to the second, which is nasb. And he says nasb is five. Al-fathatu wal-alifu wal-kasratu wal-ya'u wa-hadfu al-nuni. So the asal is going to be what? Al-fatha is the asal, which is the haraka, right? And four are going to be the what? Four are going to be far'iyya. But there's a haraka in there as well. That's why I say haraka is not always, kasra is a haraka. And it's in there. Normally that far'a is the حروف. Are you with me, brothers? So what's the first one? Al-Fatha, which is the asal. How much enta there? The author is going to bring it later. Only three do. Ism al-mufrad, jam'u al-taksir, and al-fi'l al-mudari' alladhi lam yattasil bi akhiri shay. All of those three are marfu'un with what? Sorry, mansubun with what? Mansubun with fatha. The alif, which is the niyaba, which is the far'iyya. Faraya is that alif. Which one enters there? The author is going to bring it later. Al-Asma'ul Khamsa. And the kasra, what enters there? Jam'ul Mu'annath Salim. And then the ya, the author mentioned, what enters there is two. Jam'ul Mudhakkar Salim and Al-Muthanna. And then Hadful Noon, what enters there is Af'alul Khamsa. The author is going to bring each one. Now.
تكون علامة للنصب في ثلاثة مواضع: فالاسم في الاسم المفرد جمع التكسير والفعل المضارع إذا دخل عليه ناصب ولم يتصل بآخره شيء.
Now the author goes into the four, five. He goes into the first one, which is فتحة. How many enter it? I already told you it's three. اسم مفرد جمع التكسير الفعل المضارع الذي لم يتصل بآخره شيء. Are you with me, brothers? But there has to enter onto it. There has to enter onto it adawat al-nasb. What's adawat al-nasb? They are letters, but they are words, sorry, that if they go before the fi'l mudari', they force the fi'l mudari' to be mansub. Okay? And that, inshallah ta'ala, adawat al-nasb, will be taking it, inshallah ta'ala, when we come to babu marfu'at al-asma, inshallah ta'ala. Sorry, babu mansubat al-asma.
وأما الألف فتكون علامة للنصب في الأسماء الخمسة نحو رأيت أباك وأخاك وما أشبه ذلك.
Now the second one, which is the alif. The alif is the second, which is far'iyah. So it's the first for the far'iyah. So we have four far'iyah and one asliyah. The first of the far'iyah is the alif. So the it becomes وَأَمَّا الْأَلِفَ تَكُونُ عَلَمَةً لِلنَّصْبِ in how many places? I already told you, it's one. What is it? أَسْمَاءُ الْخَمْسَةِ The five sisters. Okay? Such as رَأَيْتُ أَبَاكَ I saw your father وَأَخَاكَ and your brother. صح؟ So you say رَأَيْتُ رَأَى فِعْلُ مُضَارِعٍ مَبْنِيٌ عَلَى الْفَتْحِ لَا مَحَلَّ لَهُ مِنَ الْإِعْرَابِ مَنَعَ مِنْ ظُهُورِهَا التَّعَذُّرِ ضمير متصل في محل رفع فاعل أباك مفعول به مصوب وعلامة نصبه الفتحة لأنه اسماء الخمسة I have to give the reason ألف sorry الألف sorry الألف لأنه اسماء الخمسة لأنه اسم من اسماء الخمسة it's a noun from the nouns of اسماء الخمسة yeah. We know what the conditions are already which is the previous conditions that have been mentioned now Now the kasra, it's only inside what? So the kasra, look at the plural feminine, they're a problem. The plural feminine is a problem. She wants to be mansoob with what? Kasra, a'udhu billah. Sah? Mansoobun bil kasrati. That's what she wants to do. Let her do it. So you say, رَأَيْتُ الْفَاطِمَاتِ صح? I saw the فَاطِمَاتِ the women. So you say, الْفَاطِمَاتِ That's what you say. Okay?
وَأَمَّا الْيَاءُ فَتَكُونُ عَلَامَةً لِلنَّصْبِ فِي
تَثْنِيَةً وَالْجَمْعِ Now the author is going into the ya, which is the third type of عَلَامَةً فَرْعِيَةً He mentions two. جمعه المذكر السالم صح and the مثنى so the جمع here he means جمع مذكر سالم that's what he means so for example you say رأيت الأستاذين الأستاذين هي مفعول به منصوب وعلامة نصبه الياء صح لأنه why because it's مثنى And the noon here is عِوَضٌ عَلِي التَّنْوِينِ في الاسم المفردي. رَأَيْتُ الْمُسْلِمِينَ مُسْلِمِينَ here is what? It is مَفْعُولٌ بِهِ مَنْصُوبٌ وَعَلَامَةُ فَتْحِهِ الْيَاءُ لِأَنَّهُ جَمْعُ الْمُذَكَرِ السَّالِمِ And the noon is what? عِوَضٌ عَلِي التَّنْوِينِ في الاسم المفردي. We didn't talk about this. We didn't speak about the issue of تنوين and the types they are. Noon tanween al-iwad, right? We're not going to go into it right now. We mentioned four, but I'm just mentioning that as a side point. Hey, carry on. The fifth one is what?
وَأَمَّا حَفُ النُّونِ فَيَكُونُ عَلَامَةً لِلنَّصْبِ فِي الْأَفْعَالِ الْخَمْسَةِ الَّتِي رَفَعَهَا بِثُبَاتِ النُّونِ
الَّتِي رَفَعَهَا
بِثُبَاتِ النُّونِ
The author here now talks about the fifth one, which we will say is the fourth one for the far'iyah, right? So what is مرصوب بحذف النون? What is مرصوب بحذف النون? أفعال الخمسة, right? Remember we said it's not good to call it أفعال الخمسة. It's better to call it and it's correct to call it what? أمثال أمثلة الخمسة. So now before it was يفعلون, right? يفعلون it used to be يفعلون تفعلون يفعلان تفعلان تفعلين, right? That's how it used to be. Let the word lad go before it, which is adawatu. Adawatu nasbi, right? It becomes what? When it becomes lan yaf'alu. What happened? It is mansub with what? Bihadfi nuni. You remove the noon. The noon is absent. Okay, because it's af'alul khamsa. Hiya. We've now finished mansubat. Now the author, rahimahullah ta'ala, he spoke about and he finished talking about two of the most important chapters. What were they? Al-Raf'u? Why do we say it's the most important ones? It's because it's mushtarakun bayna al-asma'i wal-af'al. that sama and the af'al share those two. From the eight that I spoke about before, which i'rab is done on, which is what? Ism al-mufrad, muthanna, jam' al-mudhakkar al-salim, jam' al-ithsalim, jam' al-taksir, isma' al-khamsa, and af'al al-khamsa, and al-fi'l al-mudari' alladhi lam yattasil bi akhiri shay. Those eight, they're not going to come to us anymore, all together at the same time. Are you with me, brothers? Now here, alamatul khafdi, the only ones that are going to come here are what? Six. They dropped now from eight to six now. Are you with me, brothers? Except that now, the isim mufrad broke into two. That's the only issue that happened now. This is the problem with ajrumi again. That mutamim is better. Mutamima from the beginning, it tells you that isim mufrad is two types. And that the jab'u taksir is two types. It tells you that there's a jam'u mufrad, ism mufrad, a singular noun that is known what? Munsarif. And an ism mufrad which is ghayru munsarif. That a jam'u taksir is jam'u taksir which is munsarif. And a jam'u taksir which is ghayru munsarif. It tells you from the beginning. Who does that? Mutamimatul ajrumiya. Here now it's problematic for the teacher to say to you that ism mufrad is two types. You're going to be like, why didn't you tell us all along? Sah? Here he drops the bomb at the person. No, let me take that back. He doesn't drop no bomb. Yeah. Take that back. Quickly. I meant here he confuses us. Okay? The author here, he confuses us by saying to us that there's something called mamnu' min as-sarf. He should have told us from the get-go that the ism mufrad is two types, munsarif, ghayr munsarif. And then the jam'u taksir is two types, munsarif and ghayr munsarif. So that's why it becomes more in number here. He just broke the ism mufrad into two and the jam'u taksir into two. Does that make sense? Or else we're just with what? We're actually still at the six. Does that make sense? Am I making sense? Jameel. The alama asliya is what? Kasra. Kasra alama asliya. How much enter there? Ism mufrad. Jam'u taksir. Jam'u al-natisalim. They're the ones that enter here. The ism mufrad that enters here is not just anymore called ism mufrad only. It has to be what? Ism al-mufrad al-munsarif. What does it mean al-munsarif like it? It means الَّذِي يَقْبَلُ الصَّرْفَ وَالصَّرْفَ تَنْوِين. Accepts tanween. There are some words that in the Arabic language it doesn't accept tanween. Are you with me, brothers? So when they say to you, this ism is munsarif, it means tanween can enter it. There's some nouns that can't work with tanween. Why? We'll take the mutamimatul ajrumiyyah. The reason for why they can't. Jam'u taksir here is what? Also al-munsarif. Jam'u taksir al-munsarif. What does al-munsarif mean? Alladhi yaqbalu at-tanween. Alladhi yaqbalu الصرفة. What does صرف mean? وهو التنوين. And it is تنوين. Are we together? Is that crystal clear? So for example, the word Muhammad, is it اسم مفرد منصرف? Yes. Can you say محمدا? Can you say محمد? Can you say محمد? You can. So Muhammad is منصرف. Good. That's اسم المفرد المنصرف. What about rijal? Rijal is what? Jam'u taksir, right? We took it before. It's a broken plural, right? Is it munsarif? Yes, it is. It is munsarif. You can say rijalun, rijalin, rijalan. Sah? Are you with me, brothers? Good. The third one for the kasra is what? Jam'u al-mu'annath al-salim, as the author mentions. Good. We now finished alama asliya. The alama far'iyya is two. They are ya ala fatha. The ya is three. The ya is what? Three. Al asma' al khamsa, al muthanna, and al jam'u al mudhakkar al salim. Those three are the ya. They fall under the ya. Then we're now left with the what? Al fatha. The fatha here is the mamnu' min as-sarf. From who, lakin? Huwa mamnu' min as-sarf here? Isim mufrad? Ana? Jam'u taksir. Are you with me, brothers? Because the isim mufrad and jam'u taksir enter the fatha. And they also enter the kasra. You're going to say to me, how is it going into both? When it went into the fatha, it was al ism al mufrad al munsarif. Now that it is entered fatha, it is al ism al mufrad ghayr al munsarif. And al jam' al taksir, which is ghayr al munsarif. It doesn't accept sarf. I will take what that means very well. Ayah.
فأما الكسرة فتكون علامة للفضل في ثلاث مواضع في الاسم المفرد المنصرف وجمع التكسير المنصرف وجمع المؤنث السالم.
There is, the author tells you the three. The three that enter under kasra. There you go. It's written there for you. All I'm saying is all written in the book. So if you have the book with you and you're looking, it will be there for you. The kasra here is the three. Ism al-mufrad, al-munsarif, jam' al-taksir, al-munsarif, and the third one which is jam' al-mu'annath al-salim. We've taken three of those. Hey?
وأما الياء فتكون علامة للخفض في ثلاث مواضع في الأسماء الخمسة وفي التثنية والجمع.
Now the author goes into the other three, which is الأسماء الخمسة. الأسماء الخمسة. And the مثنى and the jam'a. Here, whenever he says jam'a like that unrestrictedly, what does he mean? Jam'u al-mudhakkar al-salim. Hayya. An example would be for all of them is, for example, asma'u al-khamsa would be farihtu bi abika. Sah. Example would be muthanna, it will be marartu bil amirayni. Sah. Al-amirayni here is what? Is this majrur wa alamatu jarrihi aliyya li'annahu مثنى. And جمع ذكر السالم is what? سلمت على المجتهدين. سلمت على المجتهدين. المجتهدين here is what? مجرور بعلى. اسم مجرور رأي وعلامة جره الياء. لأنه جمع ذكر السالم. هيا. Good. الحمد لله. الله أكبر. هيا سعى 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 سعى.
وأما الفتحة فتكون على المثل الخفض في الاسم الذي لا ينصرف.
Now the author goes into the last one, which is the most annoying one. Before we were going in a nice flow, it was making sense, it was eight. We're just dealing with the eight. Now what he did was he broke the ism mufrad and the jam' al-taksir into two. Are you with me? That's all he did, nothing big. Don't let it confuse you. Does it make sense? It's just the ism mufrad is two types. And the jam' al-taksir is two types. Munsarif, غير munsarif. For the ism, mufrad. Jam' al-taksir, munsarif, غير munsarif. We know what munsarif means, right? Good. Now he wants to tell you that both of those who are ism mufrad, which is الذي لا ينصرف, ism mufrad الذي لا ينصرف, and also the جمع التكسير الذي لا ينصرف, both of those are مجرور بالوات بالفتحة, مخفوض بالفتحة. They do it as فتحة. So for example, where you said مررت بالأميرين. Are you with me? If I turn the word marartu, I came by bi ahmada or bi ahmadi. Huh? What do you say? Marartu, I came by. Do you say bi ahmada or you say bi ahmadi? Bi ahmada. Even though the hasf jar before it. Ahmada is what it becomes. It can't be Ahmadi. It should have become Ahmadi. The reason is because Ahmad here is a what? Ism mufrad, which is alladhi la yansarif. It's annoying. It doesn't accept sarf. Are you with me? You with me? Fatima. Fatima, she's the same. Are you with me? What do you say, Fatima? Marartu bi Fatima ta or bi Fatimati? Ta. Why? It is ism mufrad alladhi la yansarif. Are you with me, brothers? This is where people will catch you out. They'll catch you out because the reason why they'll catch you out is because the norms, people kind of forget that this is not from those that accept the kasra. It doesn't accept the kasra. You're going to say, but it's ism mufrad. La yansarif. La yansarif. Sah? And there's two reasons why it doesn't accept sarf. Pay attention first. First point, before I mention the two reasons, is the reason, who is the one that doesn't accept tanween? Remember when we were talking about alamatul ismi, what did we say? The distinct characteristics for it was what? What was alamatul asma? Tanween was part of the asma's signs. That's what it's known for. Sahih, brothers. Are you with me? Does af'al accept signs? Does af'al accept tanween? The reason why the ism here, Ahmed, doesn't accept tanween because it resembles a verb. It resembles a verb. It looks like a verb. And because it looks like a verb, it is not going to accept tanween, because a verb doesn't accept tanween. Does it accept tanween? Have you ever seen a verb with tanween on it? So now it resembles it. What does it resemble the verb in? It resembles in it two things. Are you with me, brothers? It resembles the verb in two things. Two things is what? Two illatayni far'iyatayni, two sub-branches. One of it goes back to the binyatul kalima, it goes back to the lafz of the word. So the first one is the wording itself. Okay? And the other one goes back to the meaning. So it resembles the verb either in the wording and the structure of the wording. Or it resembles it in what? The meaning. Are you with me, brothers? We won't go too deep, we'll stop there, inshallah. That's all we need to know for now. Mutamimatu al-ajrumiyya, we'll go into alamiyya, wasfiyya, you know, that's what we'll do more. Sah? Here, we just need to know this about. Okay, brothers? Or it goes over your head and you don't understand much. Does that make sense, brothers? Hey, let's go to alamatu. Alamata al-jazm. Now the author goes into, we finished jar, right? Khaf. Did we finish khaf? We finished khaf. Khaf was a distinct character. Khaf was a distinct sign for who? Ism. Are you with me, brothers? Jazm. Jazm is a distinct sign for who? Huh? Fi'l. Are you with me, brothers? So now, how much are going to drop from us? From the eight? Six drop. It won't come to us anymore. Who's going to come to us only? Two. What are the two that's going to come to us? فعل المضارع الذي لم يتصل بآخره شيء. And what? أمثل أفعال الخمسة. Let's just keep it simple here. أفعال الخمسة. Those two. الفعل المضارع الذي لم يتصل بآخره شيء. And what? That's all that comes here. Are you there? Are you with us, brothers? Let's look at it now, eh? The first one is what? Sukun. Sukun is the alama what? Sukun is alama asli, right? It's the original one. And what falls under there is the fi'l al-mudari' alladhi lam yatasil bi akhirihi shay' that also is not mu'tal. Mu'tal here means that it doesn't have the three naughty letters. The three naughty letters, they're very naughty. What are they? Waw, Alif, Y. See how that part goes through? Y. Waw, Alif, Ya, right? How do you say Y? Those three letters are naughty letters. So here the first one is, it has to be Sahih al-Akhir. The ending has to be correct, healthy. Okay? It has to be healthy. If it's not healthy, so right now the فعل المضارع الذي لم يتصل بآخره شيء is divided into what? He broke into two. صحيح الآخر and معتل. صحيح الآخر means what? It doesn't finish with واو ألف ياء. Are you with me, brothers and sisters? And معتل, which is the one that finishes with what? Waw, Alif, and Ya. Are you with me, brothers? That's what the author breaks it into. So when you're at the sukun, which is majzumun, wa alamatu jazmihi sukun, you say, it is that it has to be first of all number one, al fi'l al mudari', which is the one we used to call fi'l al mudari' alladhi lam yattasil bi akhri shay'. And also, it has to be sahih al akhir. The ending has to be sahih, correct. correct from what? Healthy, nurtured, goes to the gym, pays for his membership. Sah? Yeah, brothers. Why would it do that? Because waw alif ya is not attached to the ending of it. Then we are left with alama far'iyyah. Alama far'iyyah. Alama far'iyyah is what? Is the sub-branch. And the author here only mentioned what? Hadf, right? Hadf. Are you with me, brothers? And what falls under the hadf? Two. What are the two that fall under it? The second one that I mentioned for the فعل المضارع الذي لم يتصل بآخر شيء. What was the opposite to صحيح الآخر? What was the opposite to it? معتل. معتل is number one here. Two is going to be what? أفعال الخمسة. Are you with me? So we broke the فعل المضارع الذي لم يتصل بآخر شيء. We broke it how much? Into two. صحيح الآخر, معتل. The صحيح الآخر goes into the سكون. The معتل is the one that goes into the حذف. And then the last one, which is أفعال الخمسة. Good? Shall I repeat that one more time? So here, we said, this is جزم we're at, right? Where we at? We're at جزم. جزم is an علامة unique for who? فعل. When we were doing the eight, and we were categorizing the eight, how much did we bring from the فعل? Two. فعل مضارع, we brought two out of it. الَّذِي لَمْ يَتَصِلْ بِآخِرِهِ شَيْءٍ And the second one is what? أَفْعَالُ الْخَمْسَةِ أَفْعَالُ أَفْعَالُ الْخَمْسَةِ is what we brought out of it. Okay, good. The فعل المضارع الَّذِي لَمْ يَتَصِلْ بِآخِرِهِ شَيْءٍ All that time we were just taking it as one. Whether it's صحيح الآخر or معتل الآخر was all one for us before. When it came here, the author broke it into two. فعل المضارع which is what? معتل. Defected. أنا فعل مضارع الذي لم يتصل بآخره which is what? صحيح. The صحيح one is the one that falls under the سكون. The صحيح falls under the سكون. It falls under the علامة أصلية. The معتل, the فعل مضارع which is معتل, it falls under the حذف. So it's the first type of حذف. حذف means to remove. The way it's going to be dealt with is that letter that's defected is going to be removed from it. And the third one which is أفعال الخمسة. أفعال الخمسة. Brothers and sisters, we have, with the permission of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, His aid and His support, we have finished باب معرفة علامات الإعراب, right? We finished, صح? We did all four that were needed. We finished الرفع والنصب والخفض والجزم. صح, brothers? I'm going to quickly do a quick recap of all of it, one more time. Fast, quick. Yeah? All of that which I did, and I'll do it in 40 seconds. 45 seconds. The alamat al-i'rab are categorized into two. Alamat which are usul, foundations, fundamentals. Alamat which are furu', which are sub-branches. That's one point. The alamat which are usul are four. Al-dhamma, wal-fatha, wal-kasra, wal-sukun. The alamat which are far'iyyah are ten. Al-wawu, wal-alif, wal-nun, and all of them wal-dhamma. Four which are fatha. Al-alif, wal-kasra, wal-ya, wa-hathfu, nun. And two which are in kasra, which is al-ya, wal-fatha. And one which is under sukun, which is hadf. Khalas? That's what we took. This structure is back to front. The way I did it was different. Remember? The way I did it was what? We looked at the wordings. We took eight. It's mufrad. Muthanna. Jam dhakr salim. Jam mu'annath salim. Jam taksir. Asma'ul khamsa. فعل المضارع الذي لم يتصل بآخر شيء أفعال الخمسة, right? We got the eight like that, and we said with the eight, the way it's done is that it enters into the رفع and it enters into the نصب, and six of those enter into خفض with us knowing that the اسم مفرد now is not only one anymore, it is اسم مفرد which is منصرف and غير منصرف, And the jam'u taksir is not one only anymore. Which is munsarif and ghayr munsarif, jam'u taksir. We said that. And then we came to the jazm and we said, it is two that come with us here. Which is al-fa'l al-mudari' al-ladhi lam yattasil bi-akhirhi shay. And af'al al-khamsa. Keeping in mind that the af'al, fa'l al-mudari' al-ladhi lam yattasil bi-akhirhi shay, we categorized it into two. What was it? Sahih al-akhir and mu'tal. That's what we did, right? That's the khulasa of what happened here. What took place? If a police officer told you to report what just took place, this is what you would say, right? This is just what took place. Now we're going to go into the author trying to summarize what it is. Sah? He's going to try to summarize it. Hey, yeah? We're not going to speak over it. We're just going to keep it moving because this is already spoken about. We already spoke about all of this. What he's saying right now is what I already told you guys. Hey, fadl.